Thank you for the introduction. I would like to thank Canon for this great opportunity to share information about the quantitative ultrasound imaging to assess MASLD. We commonly talking, that's my disclosures. In terms of MASLD, we always talking about what it is and the clinical importance to detect the early stage of MASLD diagnosis. What a quantitative ultrasound biomarker can do in the MASLD management. And I'd like to share our small pilot study. MASLD is a metabolic dysfunction associated steatotic liver disease. It extended from a conventional non-alcoholic fatty liver disease because hepatic steatosis is not a single disease limited in liver itself. Hepatic steatosis is recognized as an independent risk factor for metabolic dysfunction, type 2 diabetes, and cardiovascular mortalities. It is very important to detect the early stages of MASLD because pathological changes like fatty accumulation and inflammation in the liver in early stage can be revised with a proper treatment or management. However, once disease progresses to later stage and fibrosis develops, the high risk of development of the liver dysfunction, even HCC. So that's why it's very important to detect early stages and provide the patient with a proper treatment. Strategies in diagnosis of MASLD include the medical history, blood test, invasive liver biopsy histology, and non-invasive imaging techniques, CT, MRI, and ultrasound. Today, unmet clinical need is to develop quantitative ultrasound biomarkers to assess hepatic steatosis with a high accuracy, high availability, and low cost. As you know, blood tests are not sensitive to hepatic steatosis. Liver biopsy, of course, can provide the information of liver inflammation, fat content, and fibrosis. However, liver biopsy has limitations. Number one, because it's not a standard of care for patients with early stages of MASLD. And small size, very, very small. And the variation and the errors in tissue sampling and the interpretation. Lastly, potential complication from such invasive procedures. Among imaging modalities, CT and MRI have been used to assess hepatic steatosis. CT provides liver attenuation and a liver attenuation index. However, CT has a radiation exposure to all of the patients, cannot be used as screening test and repeat many, many times. MRI has been recognized as a reliable imaging modality to assess hepatic steatosis, even fibrosis, and good correlation with the liver biopsy histology, and sample size much larger, much, much larger than liver biopsy. However, there are limitations. MR imaging, contraindications, and high cost. And it is not available in rural area. That means low availability as a screening imaging technique. Over here, and my colleagues know about conventional B-mode ultrasound imaging. And it has been used for years. And look at the image. four images from a normal liver. This is a liver with mild steatosis. And this one with mild steatosis, the liver with severe hepatic steatosis. So it's just hard to tell, it's fairly mild and moderate based on B-mode image. People may interpret it as mild or maybe interpret as a moderate steatosis. What I mean by that is a conventional B-mode ultrasound. The determination and the grade of hepatic steatosis based on subjective observation and qualitative assessment, not a quantitative. Therefore, quantitative ultrasound biomarkers have been developed to assess liver pathologies, not only steatosis. Attenuation coefficient, backscatter coefficient, scatter homogeneity, and echogenicity intensity ratio for liver to the kidney can quantify liver fat. Shear wave speed can be used to assess the liver stiffness associated with the liver fibrosis, of course, other confounding factors. And the shear wave dispersion slope can be used to evaluate liver inflammation. So those aforementioned ultrasound quantitative biomarkers now available commercially on the different ultrasound scanners from different vendors. So it's my great pleasure to introduce our small pilot study. The aim of our study was to test quantitative ultrasound biomarkers for assessing hepatic steatosis. We received the RB approval and consent from all the participants. We recreated adults with no or suspicious MASLD. Ultrasound biomarkers we measured included attenuation image, attenuation coefficient from attenuation imaging, and we also measured the supramicrovascular imaging-based vascularity index in the liver parenchyma. We used PDFF and MRE as a reference standards, and we also collected biochemical markers like a blood test, liver function test, lipids, and glucose. And data analysis were performed using t-test, Spearman correlation coefficient, and the area under ROC curve. We divided, recruited 125 participants into three groups based on PDFF and MRE. 20 with a normal liver, 78 with a simple fat accumulation, 25 with liver fibrosis. And we observed significant differences in attenuation coefficient, vascularity index, and MRPDF among three groups. Here are some images I'd like to share with you. This is a PDFF, attenuation coefficient, and the vascularity index from a normal liver. You see PDFF 4.8%, attenuation coefficient 0.62, vascular index 23.8%. Those images are from a liver with mild steatosis, PDFF up to 9%, attenuation coefficient 0.72, vascular index 14%. Those images from a liver with moderate steatosis based on MRPDFF 19.1%, attenuation coefficient 0.77, vascular index 13.1%. And this is images from a liver with severe steatosis, PDFF up to 27.2%, attenuation coefficient 0.9, vascularity index down to 7% only. I like to share those images. You see on the top line, that's the attenuation coefficient measurements from different grade of steatosis based on ATI imaging. On the bottom, that's a MRI PDF, and also the measurements from different from livers with different grade of steatosis. We found a close positive correlation between attenuation coefficient and MRPDFF of the liver. Very close correlation based on Pearson analysis. So we also found a close inverse correlation between vascularity index and the PDFF in different grade of hepatic steatosis. And all of the significant differences in attenuation coefficient and the vascular index among different grades of hepatic steatosis, significant. We also observed high diagnostic performance of attenuation coefficient and the vascularity index for grading hepatic steatosis based on area under RC curve. So now we know MASLD is a high prevalence disease. Early detection plays an important role in the disease management and the treatment. MRI has proven to be reliable imaging technique in grading hepatic steatosis and fibrosis. However, reliability of quantitative ultrasound biomarkers for quantify steatosis still under clinical investigation. We noted some challenges. There are challenges in assessing liver inflammation. Use ultrasound without histology as a correlation or standard reference standard. So we look forward to future collaboration on clinical studies of MASLD. Thank you for your attention.